Hello everybody, I'm going to show you how to create the FA net for a raft with straight and curved borders, considering an opening on it using ELPLA software. Choosing FA net data button from the data tab. The FA net generation wizard appears. First form of it is the slab type, which contains a group of templates used to generate standard nets that have regular shapes. Using these templates, FANet can be generated according to the following features. Generating a FANet for square, rectangular, and irregular slabs using 6 different types of nets. These nets are a combination between rectangular and triangular elements. Generating FANet for ring slabs, circular slabs using 15 different types of nets. So, here is the raft as shown here in the figure. The raft has irregular shape, so choose irregular slab. Now we have to define the length and width of the working area. The length here will be 18 meter and the width will be 10. Click next. Then we have to define the net. Choose rectangular net. Click next. The last form of the generation wizard is the grid definition form. Here we have to define the length of the grid interval, number of grid intervals, and check if the grid intervals are constant in both x and y direction. Let the grid interval length to be 0.5 in x and y direction. So number of grid intervals in x direction will be 36 and in y direction will be 20. Click finish. A rectangular net of 18 multiplied by 10 has been created. You can either draw the raft directly on the net using slab corners button from graphical menu. Here we have three options: rectangle, circle or ellipse, and polygon. As the raft has a regular shape, so use polygon and start drawing the outside borders of the raft on the net. Or you can input the raft corner points in tabulated form using slab corners button from in table menu. The edit slab form appears. Here the raft will be defined as segments. Each has a start position and end position. The outside borders of the raft consists of 4 segments. The first one starts at 0 and 0, ends at 13 and 0. So click insert slab. Slab of 3 segments has been defined, so we have to insert another one. Now we have 4 segments, we have to define them. Here is the first segment has been drawn here. Second segment starts at 13 and 0, ends at 13 and 10. Here is the second segment. But it is an arc, not a straight line, so check use arc data and check reverse rotation direction. The third segment starts at 13 and 10, ends at 5 and 10. Here's the third segment. Here is the fourth segment has been defined automatically by connecting the third segment to the first segment. Click OK. Now the outside borders of the raft has been defined on the net. By the same way, we have to define the opening part inside the raft by using opening corners button from in table menu. Edit opening form appears. So opening inside the Raft consists of four segments. First one starts at 10 and 2, ends at 12 and 2. So click insert opening. An opening of three segments has been created, so we have to insert another one. Second segment starts at 12 and 2, ends at 12 and 8. Check use arc data and check reverse rotation direction. The third segment starts at 12 and 8, ends at 10 and 8. Fourth segment has been created automatically by connecting the third one to the first segment. Click OK. Now we have defined the boundaries of the Raft. Click FE Net Generation button. Then choose Generating FE Net. The FE net of the Raft appears. We can choose smoothing mesh. This option is used to optimize the dimension of the FE net by making all elements have nearly the same area as possible. Now the FE net of the Raft has been defined.